to one and all present here, all my Facebook friends, and all the people involved in the Anand Marg Prachara, the volunteers, my friends, and my sincere pranams to Swami Divya Chetanaji, who actually introduced me to this particular talk today. It has been a coincidental thing that I got involved with this particular project. It was 2 years back that I was introduced to this study of Prabhat Sangeet by my professor and guide, Professor S.N. Sushila. I, being a student of Carnatic music and pursuer of Carnatic music for the past 25 years, it has been a new thing for me to get introduced to this particular Prabhat Sangeet, because I have always been studying the South Indian music, and Prabhat Sangeet is an amalgamation of so many different styles of music, and this is very new to my repertoire. So today I would like to talk a few words about this music to all my friends present here, and any mistakes inadvertently made, I would like to you to pardon me for the same. I would like to start this particular talk with a song composed by Anand Murthy ji, that is P.R. Sarkar ji. Tvam mama priya hai, tvam asi ameya. Tvam mama priya hai, tvam asi ameya. Vasasi manasi prajaraja. Tvam mama priya hai, tvam asi ameya. Vasasi manasi prajaraja. चंदन चर्चित कौस्तुभ निंदित, चंदन चर्चित कौस्तुभ निंदित, किंशुक धर मथुराराज. त्वं मम प्रियः त्वमसि अमेय, वससि मनसि प्रजराज. తమాలని పవని వేణుకాస్వరని, తమాలని పవని వేణుకాస్వరని, హసదసి ప్రియ మమ శయ चिन्तायामसि कृपयां स्नपयसि, चिन्तायामसि कृपयां स्नपयसि, महसि अन्तरे राज, वससि मनसि व्रजराज. त्वं मम प्रियः त्वमसि अमेय, वससि मनसि व्रजराज. आगच्छतु प्रिय मर्मे गभीरे मम, स्वयं भरा प्रीति. पीतं भरा द्योति स्वयं भरा प्रीति, विश्वातीत अधिराज भससि मनसि व्रजराज त्वं मम प्रियः त्वमसि अमीय भससि मनसि व्रजराज 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 I should say, this is a blessed opportunity for me to begin my talk with a song of Krishna. As you all know, today happens to be the Krishna Janmashtami for many of us who are celebrating here in South India. I would like to start my talk with a brief introduction of music of Indian classical system. I would like to mention the term classical because even Prabhat Sangeet, according to me, comes under the category of classical music, for which I will be giving you substantial evidence and also my analysis for the same. There has been three periods in Indian classical music. One is the ancient period, one is the medieval period, and also next the modern period. Ancient period is from the Bharata, who has the fame of Natya Shastra. From Bharata to Matanga's period is considered to be the ancient period of Indian classical system. The next period is the medieval era, which is from the 8th century, that is from the Matanga period till the 12th century, and then comes the modern period, which is from the 12th century onwards, all the different milestones that has been achieved by the Indian classical system. Under the modern period, today my focus will be more on the modern period, that too the period after 19th century, because it is the period, I can say, that it is the golden period of Indian classical system for many reasons. One main reason has been the various experiments and the scientific analysis that has been done about the Indian classical system has been documented, as well as the practical illustration has been also documented in order to project it. Most of the classical analysis that has been done in our previous ancient period has no doubt the theory analysis, but the practical illustration has not been documented because of the lack of recording system. So today, if we want to understand how the ancient period music was like, It is very difficult to understand because we do not have any evidence, and there are no people after those generations who have been able to sing and show us this is how it was. Now, 19th century and onwards, that is called as the Renaissance period in the Indian classical music system, I can say it's the golden period because of these following reasons. In this modern period, does the talk of Prabhat Sangeet also emerge? Prabhat, what do you mean by Prabhat? Prabhat means sunrise. The sunrise itself, the word sunrise itself, gives you the novel idea. It is about the new beginning, and it's very refreshing. It's like how we get up every day with a refreshing mind. Even the word Prabhat also portrays the same feeling. So Prabhat Sangeet is the songs of the new dawn. These pieces that was composed, it goes to, the credit goes to Anand Murthy ji, that is popularly known as Anand Murthy ji, but who is actually the original name of Anand Murthy ji has been P.R. Sarkar, that is Prabhat Ranjan Sarkar. And most of you here who are involved in the service, in the voluntary service of Anand Mar Pracharak, very well know that Anand Mar Pracharak started in 1955 by P.R. Sarkar. Now, in this context, I would like to talk about the word Vagyayakara. I would like to talk about this word Vagyayakara being a South Indian music, because in South Indian music we have this term Vagyayakara, which means Vak plus Gaya. Vak is the word, Gaya means music. So the composer who composes both the music as well as the lyric is called as the Vagyayakara. So all our composers, that is the Tyagaraja, the Muthuswami Dikshitar, Shama Shastri, the trinities of Carnatic music, have brought about this new renaissance with the term Vagyayakara, because they were the tunesmiths and also the wordsmiths for the particular song. So I would like to say that Anand Murthy ji is also definitely a Vagyayakara, because he wrote the song and he also tuned it for the benefit of mankind. The very first song that he composed, I would like to sing and show you how it is. Mm-hmm. বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো আলোরই ঝরনা ধরার পানে, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো আলোরই ঝরনা ধরার পানে, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো আধারের ব্যথা শায়ন প্রাণী, আধারের ব্যথা শায়ন প্রাণী, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো ঘুমের ঘর ভাঙে নর গানি গানি, ঘুমের ঘর ভাঙে নর গানি গানি, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো, বন্ধু হে নিয়ে চলো। So this was the very first song which Anand Murchi ji composed in 1982. Now I should make a mention that Anand Murchi ji composed nearly 5,018 songs, and it is not an exaggeration. This 5,018 songs composed within a span of 8 years, from 1982 to 1990. We have seen many composers with hundreds of compositions, with 200s, with 300s, but 5,000 is a very big number. So the credit goes to Anand Murthy ji, and I would definitely say he has been a magnanimous personality to have composed so many compositions. And these compositions have a wide spectrum of different themes and different varieties. There are variety in its style, variety in its language, variety in its theme, variety in various other flavors and styles. And what are the different styles that he has composed in? On different deities, that is all the Indian deities, Shiva, it can be Shiva, it can be Krishna, it can be goddess, all the different deities. In different languages, he has composed in Indian languages like Bengali, Sanskrit, in Hindi, and he has also composed in international languages. Around 40 songs of his compositions are international languages, like in Scandinavian, in Persian, in Chinese, in Arabic, and also in English. And what are the other kinds of songs that he has composed? He has composed on national festivals, he has composed on religious festivals, he has songs on climate, on weather, on children, and there are patriotic songs, and there are women-oriented songs, and there are songs on important personalities. That is, it could be Rabindranath Tagore, or it could be Lord Buddha, and he has composed on nature and also different Kirtan Shaili songs. So these are the different repertoire he has to his credit, and you can understand when he has composed so many songs, his idea of music has been very universal and not stuck to one particular style or one particular theme. And what are the structure of songs? Now we have to deal with the structure of songs. When we look into the scripts of Anand Murthy ji, there is no mention of the udatta or anadatta, the swaras or the rhetorics or the aesthetics or the meter or the tala. There are no such mention in his books, but there has been a great lineage that has been followed since its inception. There are people who are following his music as sung by him, because he himself was a great musician of great caliber, and he has tuned it and he has also recorded it for the other people to follow, and people have been following the same structure and have been singing it as per the same notation, and that's a great thing to mention here. And some of these songs, it is also very significant to note that these songs are just not songs which can be sung as a solo. It can also be incorporated as a choir. You can add harmonics to it, you can add chords to it in a Western style or as a solo rendering. In all these styles, it is as good as it is in its own way. And what are the shades of, most of his songs do have the styles of Hindustani. And what are the styles that he has adopted? The songs are of the style of Tappa, Jhumar, Kirtana, Ghazal, Qawwali, and also I should mention the tradition of Baul. The tradition of Baul is a great tradition that was in the West Bengal during the 15th century. Definitely, there is a brief introduction required that has to be made here in order to understand what this Baul tradition is all about. As I told you, It is a tradition that was followed in the 15th century, and it has been documented in the texts of West Bengal that people who belong to the Bol tradition were nomadic bards, or they were minstrels who used to sing, going from place to place with music as their religion. They were not people who were attached to one particular region, but their music, their religion was music. Now, when I say that they were not attached to any particular religion, it should not be confused with the terms agnosticism or atheism, because those two terms definitely mean different, whereas the Bol tradition talks about neo-humanism. I will go in detail about the neo-humanism after a while. This is one thing, and the songs of this particular tradition are more of folk in tradition. I would like to sing one song and show you how it could have been. This is a song of Prabhat ji, Anand Murthy ji, but you can see the shades of Bol tradition that he has adopted in his song. Connected the concept of Sakara Brahma with Nirakara Brahma. What is Sakara Brahma? Sakara Brahma is that particular God whom we visualize, whom we give a form and pray to God, thinking he could be like this, in this form or that particular form, with a flute in his hand, with more punk on his head, or with snake around his neck. These are the different forms that we give and we picturize in our mind in order to worship a God. This is for a layman to understand the concept of God, whereas Nirakara Brahma is that particular understanding of God who has no form at all. God is everywhere. He is present in everything and in every being. He is in the nature, he is in the insect, he is in the human being, he is in even non-living, unanimated things. So this is the idea of Nirakara Brahma. He can take any shape or he may not take any shape. So I would like to connect the compositions of Anand Murthy ji from Sakara Brahma to Nirakara Brahma, because he has composed many compositions for various deities. For it could be Lord Buddha, Lord Krishna, Lord Goddess, or Lord Shiva. And he has also composed a song on Nirakara Brahma where he mentions no God, because as I told you, he always was connected, probably he was influenced by the Bol tradition, which did not believe in any, but which did not connect itself, not believe, it did not connect with any religion and did not want to give any kind of a form. So there is this particular song I would like to sing and show you, where there is no connection to any particular form of God, but the whole world is a God.
Malik ho mere, 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 dil ke arz pe baso ji, Malik ho mere, dil ke arz pe baso ji. मालिक हो मेरे दिल के आरस पे बसो जी नव चक्र की नव चक्र की कलियां खिल रही है, नव चक्र की कलियां खिल रही है, नव चक्र की कलियां खिल रही है। उनकी खुशबू से रमते रहो जी, मालिक हो मेरे दिल के अरस पे बसो जी, मालिक हो मेरे।
See, in this particular song, there is no mention of any particular god. It could be Hinduism, the god associated with Hinduism, the god associated with the Christianity, or the Muslims, or the Zoroastrian, or Buddhism, Jainism. You could, Malik can be from any religion. So that shows how Anand Murthy ji had the attitude of universal brotherhood. So that is what is the concept of neo-humanism, which I spoke to you a few minutes ago. Neo-humanism is that particular responsibility of each individual present in this world, that he has to take care of his fellow beings, be it from any religion, be it from any caste, any creed. The whole world is my family. Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, what we call in India, is all about neo-humanism. So all his songs and all his compositions reflect the shades of neo-humanism, which is something which each individual, each of us have to follow when we belong to the culture or the religion of music, because music is beyond all religion. So Anand Murthy ji was the chief propagator or promoter of neo-humanism. So what is the objective of this particular Prabhat Sangeet today? Internal spiritual enlightenment, cultural tolerance, and positivity in life. These are the basic qualities that it propagates and promotes through its songs. The songs are sung in order to bring positivity in life and also to come from the darkness to the light, to the enlightenment. So this is the objective of Prabhat Sangeet. So in Prabhat Sangeet, we also come across, when I spoke to you about different kinds of songs and which has different themes, we also come across different Navavidha Bhaktis. In Indian spirituality, we talk about Navavidha Bhakti. Navabhakti Vidha Bhakti is that particular love towards God in different forms, as in as a friend, as a lover, as a dasa, as a slave, as a husband, as a wife. Whatever roles we are taking in our lives, the love we show towards the other person can be redirected to the Almighty or the Supreme Power, and that itself becomes the spirituality. And this is called as the spiritual enlightenment within ourselves. So these are the things that Anand Murthy ji brought about in his compositions. And one last thing I would like to talk about is the compositions when compared with other approaches. Now when we compare the Prabhat Sangeet with the Hindustani music or with the Carnatic music, we do not see too much of improvisations in this kind of music. Why do we not see the improvisation? Is because the whole focus here is not about improvising the raga, but the focus is more about the lyrics of the raga, the content of the raga, and what it actually suggests. What do the lyrical content suggest? This should be our focus. And the mindset when composing these songs, the mindset of Anand Murthy ji has been to cater to the society at large. The word ananda, which means bliss, is very frequently used in almost all these kinds of compositions. Bliss represents ultimate happiness, which is beyond all materialistic possessions. The penultimate destination for all humans is salvation, which is very often made to ponder through these compositions. The Navavidha Bhakti concept, which is extensively touched upon by all these composers, require special attention. On the whole, the motto of such composition is the revival of rich traditions through fine arts to achieve universal harmony, or in other words, as I already spoke about it, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, world is one family. This has been the motto of Prabhat Sangeet. So as I told you, he composed nearly 5018 songs in a span of 8 years, from 1982 to 1990. There is one, that there is the last song that he composed, which I would like to sing and show you.
Amra gore nobo gurukul, amra gore nobo gurukul, jnane raloke rangiye dobo. আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, জ্ঞানের আলোকে রঙিয়ে ডোব, জ্ঞানের আলোকে রঙিয়ে ডোব, প্রতিটি কুড়িপুল, প্রতিটি কুড়িপুল, গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, কেহ না তাকিবে দূরে, তাকিবে দূরে, বাজাবো প্রতিটি তারে, কেহ না তাকিবে দূরে, বাজাবো প্রতিটি তারে, বাঁধিব প্রতিদরে, বাঁধিব প্রতিটি দরে, হে মনি হরে অতুল, হে মনি হরে অতুল, গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, জ্ঞানের আলোকে রঙিয়ে ডোব, আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল, আমরা গড়ে নব গুরুকুল।
This was the last song. This was the last song that Anandamurti ji composed during his lifespan. And one another significant feature about his music is that all his compositions, all his compositions have been numbered. So some of the songs which I presented today before you, the songs are, you would be amazed to know, the song, the first song that I spoke of, Tvam Mama Priyaha Tvamasi Ameya, the song on Lord Krishna, is the 3951st song. So that has been given the name as the song number 3951. And the first song, Bandhu Ye Niye Chalo, that is the first song. And the last song which I sang just now, Amra Gore Nobo Gurukul, is the 5018th song. And another song which I sang, Hey Malik Ho Mere, Malik Ho Mere in Hindi, that was the 4072nd song. So you can see how so many songs he composed for the mankind, and we have so many volunteers who are involved in propagation of these songs, and definitely it's an asset to the Indian classical system, and no doubt it can be given the title of a classical music because it has various other styles involved in it, and you can see different themes, different varieties and different shades of various cultures, and learning these songs and understanding these songs is a great asset for any classical musician. With this, I would like to conclude my particular presentation about Prabhat music. I extend my sincere pranams to Swami Divya Chetana ji for having given me this opportunity to present myself before you with this very unique theme, which is very new to me, and have learnt a lot in this journey of discovering new things through the study of Prabhat Sangeet. Namaste.